Good morning, sir. My name is Tina Netto, and I'll be the judge presiding over your hearing today. And according to your attorney, we don't need to conduct a formal arraignment. He's reviewed the charges with you, so I'm going to hear from the state first on their request for bail. Okay?
Today, we're requesting preventative detention for this defendant, Your Honor. The reason is we believe there's clear and convincing evidence that his release would pose a danger to the public. Here, the defendant is alleged to have lit and left to explode two incendiary devices. There was a thorough investigation done where the police were able to identify the vehicle who had left the devices via surveillance. We've submitted that information via affidavit to the court. They also located the defendant actually at one of the gas stations in the near area. Upon discussions with the defendant, he admitted to the conduct. As well as searching his vehicle, they found an additional incendiary device that had yet to be in place and exploded. We have great concern for the community. This is an extremely serious offense. In particular, there was one individual who was, frankly, less than a minute away from being seriously injured, if not killed. That individual noticed the smoking device on the corner on the side of the road, came over to the device, and upon realizing what it was, left. And by the time he had gotten into his vehicle and started driving away, the device exploded. That actually shattered one of the windows in his vehicle. If he had been just seconds slower at getting back to his car, we don't know exactly what would have happened. That is extremely, extremely dangerous. There will be further investigation into the defendant about exactly why he was doing what he was doing, but it doesn't matter for the purposes of bail today about why. Simply putting those types of devices anywhere in our community is an extremely dangerous thing, and the defendant should be held on bail. The further information that I have for the court that I think will help make a decision on bail, during the investigation, during speaking with the defendant, I am told by Sergeant Mount Pleasure from the Weare Police Department that he was told by the ATF agent.
The state and I already had a brief discussion about some of these statements. Can we approach briefly?
Sure. The objection based on the fact that we don't have any witness to testify.
So, Your Honor, the defendant does not have a conviction on his record, but I don't think that necessarily means that he's not a danger. Very clearly here, you place bombs within our community. That is extremely, extremely dangerous. We believe he should be held on preventative detention.
Okay, thank you. Attorney Raymond?
We're actually asking that bail be set at $1,000 cash, which is a significant amount of bail for my client to post. In September of last year, my client was actually injured in a car accident. He was actually driving his vehicle and airbag deployed for no reason. It's unclear exactly why it deployed. As a result of that, he suffered some injuries. One of the injuries he suffered was an injury to his left hand. He lost basically three fingers, as you can see. He's lost it completely. His index finger, part of his middle finger, and part of his thumb. He was rendered out of work as a result of that. I've had a chance to talk with his wife about kind of the impact that had on my client. He was out of work, but cleared to return back in November. Unfortunately, he was not initially allowed to go back to work immediately in November. Apparently, he had a more suitable role for him, I guess, within the company. Short-term disability ended for him for a period of time. They were forced to tap into their savings. They actually pay, to provide his father with some care and support because of Alzheimer's, and they're paying that out of pocket as well. But more importantly, my client's wife, and she's here today as well, said that she did see a change in him, and that she thought as though he was going through some mental health crises at that time as a result of everything that was going on. He eventually did have an opportunity to return to work, but that was in March in a much, much diminished role from what he had previously had, which was really difficult for him to cope with as well. His wife wants to support him. She's actually been in contact with a crisis counselor, Brightside Health, to work with my client. And she's got that arranged. In the event that he was released today, she can have him working with a crisis management counselor today. She's willing to, either through herself, through friends, through family, she's willing to commit that somebody will be with my client 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. They will make sure that he is not left alone, that he's with someone who can work with him. She will make sure that he's engaged in counseling, so not just crisis management, but they'll also engage in counseling. I think there's certainly a question as to whether or not the deployment of the airbag beyond the injury of his hand, whether or not there was any other kind of head trauma that he may have suffered as well. What she believes, and I think what's appropriate here, is to try to get him some services in place and to try to get him working through some of the mental health issues that have significantly changed the man he was pre-injury to the man he is today. So what we're asking for is set the bail at $1,000 cash. That's a significant amount of bail for him and his wife to come up with, especially given their current financial situation. But it's something that my client believes they can do. Put the condition that he's going to be on house arrest. He'll have to remain there. The family has indicated that somebody will be with him 24/7. Require that he has to engage in mental health counseling, starting with crisis management through Brightside, so the order could say immediately go to crisis management and then continue with mental health counseling as directed through the crisis management provider. And we can schedule this for a bail hearing in a couple weeks to monitor compliance. His wife can certainly be asked to come as well, and she can even give an update to the court, to the state, to make everyone aware that he's following through these conditions.
Okay, thank you. I presume that you discussed this possibility with the state before this hearing, or is this the first time you're hearing of this offer, counsel?
I don't believe we specifically discussed the condition of his wife supervising.
Okay.
I think from the get-go, we knew this was going to be a bail hearing.
Yeah,
was able
no, that's fine.
Have contact with his wife again, spoke with her again before we came in here, okay, just to solidify what I talked with her about before.
Right. So could I see counsel up here again for just a moment? Okay, counsel?
Your Honor, I do have some concern with the defense's proposal that somebody from the defendant's family would be able to supervise him 24/7. These incendiary devices or these bombs were created in the same home where the defense is suggesting that he would be able to go back to and be supervised. One would expect that the same way that he was able to hide these creation of these bombs, he would be able to hide any other activities that he would be doing in relation to that while at home and out on bail. I do not believe that the conditions set forth by defense would alleviate the clear and convincing danger presented by the defendant at this time.
Okay.
The only thing I would add just briefly in response to that is that I think one of the significant changes here right now, it is a significant change, is that his wife now understands kind of the scope of the problem. She had some concerns before, but she certainly understands the scope of the issue now. And I have no doubt that she's going to be extremely diligent in supervising him.
Okay. All right, let me tell you what I'm going to do. These cases are never easy, and obviously the facts in this case are extremely concerning, and I do find that the state has met its burden by clear and convincing evidence to establish a danger to the community if you were released. This is the type of case that if we had pretrial services in this county, you might be an appropriate candidate for that program. But what I'm going to do, given the allegations at least early on in this litigation about some possible mental health concerns, is to allow an evaluation to occur, if you can get that set up between Raymond and the jail, and we'll see what that evaluation says, and you can request another bail review hearing later after that's complete. I'm reluctant at this stage of the game, given the seriousness of these charges, to release him outright without that evaluation. Okay? All right. Thank you. And if I could have the state upload a proposed bail order. Or is it in here already?
I was accepting
okay.
it while the hearing.
Got it. Okay. And are you done now with me?
I think the other two are going to be hearings and they're both ready.
Okay.